won't find what the Evil Devil biologist needs there, Sam. Afraid you'll just have to collect the tar yourself. She initially deployed equipment for this very purpose near a BT hotspot. But after the weather took a turn for the worse, retrieving samples herself ceased to be an option. So it's up to you now to track down all the units and do what she couldn't. Oh, and one more thing. Don't forget to bring her that ammonite the paleontologist gave you. Proceed with the utmost caution, Sam. There's a lot of ways this could go wrong.
Weapons restrictions lifted. Seven Bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until
the bomb keeping up.
All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Contribution.
Weapons restrictions lifted.
The world looked like hundreds of millions of years ago. There's just one big continent. And do you know what this is? The moon. I'll show you the real thing soon. I promise.
Thank you. to have you back. Didn't make it this far without you.
Thank you.
Scanning bridges ID. Fragile Express ID verified. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you.
I'm impressed, Sam. Not many people would have even attempted this. May I have a look? Not a scratch on it, and the tar inside is safe and secure. You do not disappoint, my friend. Connect me to the chiral network. That's where my studies will truly begin. Thank you. It goes without saying, but I am convinced that the tar is related to the BTs and the Death Stranding. After all, both it and Timefall are the defining features of the post-stranding ecosystem. Sudden environmental changes such as these invariably lead to the extinction of organisms that fail to adapt. Those that do adapt do so by virtue of enhancers, the regions of DNA that grant successful organisms their advantages. These genetic factors are the key to evolution. But there are genes which have the opposite effect, those which disadvantage organisms. Extinction factors, as they have been called. These are the seeds of advancement and obsolescence. Such factors may lie dormant within us all, a choice waiting to be made. For every being since the advent of life itself. If so, then ancient proof may hide deep within the tar. Evidence of these genetic decisions that may aid us in navigating our current crossroads. In any event, thanks to you, I can now study the composition of the tar in greater detail. I'll make sure to share any interesting results with you later.
Well done, Sam. You furthered our research into the Death Stranding in ways you cannot imagine. Thank you again for bringing me Mama's body, as well as that Ammonite. Speaking of which, my analysis of its umbilical cord is proceeding apace. I've been comparing the data against some of our restored archives. Anyway, would you mind returning to my lab? Preparations are finally complete for the chiral relay integration. If you could collect the necessary materials for the restoration work and bring them here, I would be most grateful.
Good work. New order available. Please access... parameters updated. Time limit set.
Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until the cargo verified. Thank you. Thank you for your good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Thank you, Sam. In reclaiming our past, we've uncovered a number of vital clues. Don't worry. I just got back. We have time. When you met with Mama, you experienced a strong antigen-antibody reaction, correct?
There was a BT in the room.
There was, but something else may have been causing it. I've discovered large quantities of chiral matter in Mama as well. Not just the usual kind that collects on our skin or on our suits. It's in all her cells. Cells that are no longer active. The BT you encountered there was special. It was her child, but also her own soul. Somehow, her Ka and Ha failed to separate. They must have remained connected through the umbilical cord. It's the only explanation.
Is that why I didn't get a bruise where she touched me?
Yes. And there's more.
10 seconds to cardiac arrest. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I modified the log times. Headquarters will have no record of what we say. Look, a message from Deadman. It came with the umbilical cord.
Sam, I'm sorry. You deserve to know what you were carrying. But I couldn't risk Di Hardman finding out about the case. So I had no choice but to keep it off the books. You've got to keep this between us. We still don't know if the director can be trusted. The umbilical cord was taken from Bridget Strand. I removed it in secret. The cord wasn't attached to a fetus. It was outside her body. She asked me to take care of it. Said it was the key to unlocking the Death Stranding. But she insisted that I never tell the director. The cord shows no sign of decomposition or necrotization. Almost as if it's frozen in time. I thought Hartman might be able to make sense of it. So I had it hidden with your cargo at Mountain Knot City.
Deadman's observations were accurate. It's just like Mama's corpse.
What do you mean?
I mean they share a very unique property. Both contain large amounts of chiralium in their cells. In other words, the president's cord was somehow connected to the beach, and that allowed it to escape the flow of time. I've put together the bones of a theory. It's patchy, but worth sharing, I think. Life on Earth has been rocked by many extinctions, great and small, including the Big Five. And if you examine the Earth's strata, its history, if you will, you'll find Corellium deposits that can be dated to each. What if the manifestation of beaches and other associated phenomena correspond to extinction-level events?
You mean?
Yes. Our Death Stranding could just be the latest of many. The records and research you helped us to recover strongly suggest that we are in the middle of the sixth extinction.
Sixth extinction? Come on.
You know what this is, yes?
A frozen mammoth from 10,000 years ago.
Correct. And this?
The Iceman from 5,300 years ago.
They both have the same umbilical cords.
Bullshit.
Humor me. What if the mammoth and the Iceman weren't frozen?
You're saying time stopped for them just like it did for Mama?
Unfortunately, all these specimens were lost in the Death Stranding, so there's no way to examine the genuine articles, but some fragments of data did survive. With the aid of the chiral network, we may be able to piece together something more concrete using Evo-Devo tech. All right, how's this? A dinosaur from 65.5 million years ago. Umbilical cord? Not decomposed.
Only mammals have umbilical cords.
Mm-mm. No. Only mammals have umbilical cords used for childbirth. This is something else. Call it a strand from the other side. I propose that mammalian umbilici are a sort of mimesis of the strand that then evolved over time. We shouldn't assume that everything about a Death Stranding is detrimental to life. Trilobites. Ammonites. Dinosaurs. The mammoth, the Iceman. All preserved as if frozen in time. All, without exception, found with strands. Which is to say that all may have been connected to the beach. And this, when viewed in the context of the extinction entity, EE theory, leads me to surmise that organisms with strands are in fact extinction entities. You see, Sam, EEs are connected to the beach via their strands. And it is through this connection that they somehow bring about a Death Stranding.
So you're saying Bridget was an extinction entity?
It's far too soon to say anything for certain. And since you burned her body, we may never know.
Higgs said Amelie's an EE, that she doesn't have dooms like the rest of us.
Sam, think. Assume that President Strand was an EE. Isn't it possible that her daughter is too? At the very least, Higgs may hope as much now that the President is unavailable.
So he kidnaps her for EE powers or whatever to cause a mass extinction.
Perhaps, perhaps not. I doubt a single EE is powerful enough to cause a Death Stranding, assuming Amelie is an EE.
Well, Higgs sure thinks she's got what it takes.
Indeed. And we need to get her back as soon as possible.
1 minute remaining. Please hold on to something secure.
Ah. This one is real. Sam, go west.
How do you want me to handle Die Hardman?
With your customary reserve. Nothing good will come of him learning of our suspicions. Whatever else is going on, we still need the chiral network.
Right.
Activating lab security measures. Five, four, three, two, one.
time, Sam. When you're ready, proceed to the shore of the Tar Belt and begin work on the chiral relay. Once it's ready, use the Cupid to bring it online. The necessary materials are prepped for you. Supplies are limited, so handle them with care. You'll be carrying a lot, too. All things considered, this might be one of your hardest runs to date. Hartman knows more about the site than I do, so he'll take it from here. It's about time for his wake-up call anyway.
Administering shock. Stand clear.
Right. About that way station. The site we have chosen was an original candidate for the way station we lost to the Tar Belt. Ironically, we suspended construction because we deemed it a little too unstable and not worth the risk. But this time, it's our best shot. So let's hope we weren't right to change horses in midstream. Fortunately for us, the foundation we laid down is still intact. All you have to do is transport the necessary materials to the site and finish the job. I'm afraid it's the only way we can expand the network further west and rescue Harmony. We're counting on you, Sam.
Remember, Sam, your objective is to bring a new chiral relay online by the Tar Belt. And to do that, you'll need to collect the necessary materials at Hartman's lab. Once the relay's up and running, you'll be able to proceed to Edgenot City. Good luck.
Thank you.
blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
Hold up. Let's get going.
Sam, you should be nearing the old building site. Look for the terminal and submit your materials for processing.
Next level trust is you. Next level trust is you.
Thank you.
And with that, we're all linked up. Once you cross the Tar Belt, the end will be in sight. We're this close to Emily, to America's second chance. Edgenot City awaits. The staff we're sending will start by building a safe house. Over time, they'll expand their operations and establish a new facility. In doing so, they'll carry on the legacy of the brave souls lost to the Tar. All thanks to you, Sam. Now, let's figure out how to get you across this Tar Belt.
Good morning, Sam. Blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
The only way west is through that. To make matters worse, I don't believe your PCC is capable of building anything that will get you across. There must be a way. We can't give up. Not with what's at stake. We'll see if we can't think of something here. But considering everything you've been through, I wouldn't be surprised if you've already got a few ideas of your own. I would have ever thought of that. Well done, Sam. Are you out there giving it your all, there's hope for us yet.
bridges falling down, my fair lady.
Scare the poor girl away, do you? She's in there. I can smell her. Of course, I wouldn't know for sure if it wasn't for you and your wonderful network. Bless your heart. And thank you kindly.
Careful.
Contents are fragile. Like the world and everything in it. Me, I'm no exception. I'm not the only one wearing masks either. There's your boss man. And that woman. And, oh, let's not forget little you.
Okay, it's okay.
I know it ain't easy wearing a mask all the time.
Now the mask can come off, right? Hey, hey, hey. You remember this?
Nope, nope, nope. Poor, sweet Amelie. She's holed up in the beach nearby. Tell you what say we make it a race? Whoever wins gets to usher in the end of days. Nothing like the eve of extinction bring focus to the mind. Makes folks honest. There'll be no need for masks soon. But I wonder, when you look death in her eye, will you blink?
Safe. So take your time and do it right.